Welcome everyone. This is our 21st episode of Founders Diary. The reason why we do this Founders Diary is because we know that the journey of entrepreneurship is lonely. So sometimes it's good that we can share to others, and for those who have not started their journey, you can also learn from those who have been through it. So today, I'll be accompanied by my twin brother, Ardi Setiadharma. We co-founded our own company back in 2008. And there's been ups and downs through our journey. We talk about it on the 20th episode. And today we want to invite two amazing guests from Pasar Now. So let me read a bit about what Pasar Now is. Pasar Now, bahasa Indonesia ya. Pasar Now adalah social commerce platform untuk memenuhi kebutuhan sehari-hari rumah tangga dengan harga terjangkau. Pelanggan tak perlu lagi ke pasar dan supermarket. Bisa belanja secara online melalui aplikasi atau jaringan kelompok belanja Pasar Now. Dengan mengumpulkan pesanan melalui kelompok belanja, pelanggan dapat menikmati gratis ongkos kirim tanpa minimal transaksi pembelian. Mudah dan praktis, dengan kualitas yang pasti terjamin. So without further ado, I want to invite Cindy Ozi and Donald Ono, co-founders of Pasar Now. Thank you, Cindy. Thank you, Donald, for joining us today. If you want to introduce yourself a little bit, please do. Cindy.
Sure. Cindy, you want to go first?
Okay. So, hi, guys. Thanks, Arya. Thanks, Ardi. Invite kita berdua di sini untuk ngobrol dan kenalan mengenai Pasar Now. Jadi kami dari Pasar Now, saya CMO-nya, kemudian ini Don, partner saya, CTO kami. Tadi benar kata Arya bahwa Pasar Now adalah aplikasi atau sebuah platform untuk beli fresh products ya. Terus, tapi bisnis model kita social commerce dengan model community buying atau group buying. Jadi itu kami. Donald, do you want to add something?
Just thank you so much, Arya and Ardi, for having us on your program. Thanks for inviting us.
So, mungkin sebelum mulai ya, what were you doing before you started Pasar Now? I mean, like before Pasar Now, you were Zaman Now, but before Zaman Now, what were you doing? Or have you started a startup before, or this your second, or this your
so
first time?
For myself, I've been in a few startups before this. Before start doing Pasar Now and Zaman Now, I was working at a startup in Hong Kong called Tribal Living. It's
Tribal Living.
Yes, it's an event. It's a location-based advertising solution. So if you go to a certain mall, it uses iBeacons to send you notifications and promotions about where to go, where to get vouchers, and stuff like that. And before that, I'm a full-stack JavaScript developer myself, so I'm an app developer. Before that, I made an app called Valo, which was an event-based photo sharing app. We went to Hawaii to represent Indonesia as one of the tech startups from Indonesia. It's a cool app that lets you create an event and everyone can share their pictures and review the event together.
What's the name? Sorry?
Valo. It was a while back. That was in 2015. It's no longer active. Okay. Yeah.
I see. So this would be your third startup?
Yeah.
Okay. How about you, Cindy?
Before I was working on a fashion business together with my sister, namanya Mariale. I was helping her with the marketing programs and kebanyakan juga operations. Terus before that, I was working in Fasham. It's a social enterprise startup juga, tapi bergerak di bidang pertanian. Kami bantu petani kecil dengan memberikan pinjaman, sistemnya bagi hasil.
See,
sebelum itu lagi, I worked in Garuda Indonesia.
I see. Mungkin itu ya, jadi tadi ada yang ada fashion-nya itu sehingga awalnya Zaman Now itu karena awalnya ada sedikit fashion.
Yeah.
That's why you join Zaman now ya.
Iya.
Oke, oke. So, zaman now is in the past, right? I guess.
Yeah. Well, it was what we pivoted out of. So that's what we started off with. I think our vision is still quite the same, but the way we're accomplishing our vision has changed a bit.
Yeah, yeah. So the first question is, what pivot did you make? Can you tell us a bit more about what's new with your startup?
Okay, sure. Thank you so much, Arya, for that question. Ketika kita mulai, kita bikin apps namanya Zaman Now, dan itu social commerce platform yang ditujukan untuk memberi kesempatan kepada semua orang untuk earn extra income dengan menjadi reseller dan menjual berbagai lifestyle products dan fashion. And it was doing quite well, but because of the pandemic, COVID, and circumstances changed, sekarang kita punya community group buying platform that allows people to earn extra income by selling fresh fruits and vegetables and daily needs. Namanya Pasar Now. So similar, but a little bit different.
Would you say that the pivot is really because of the pandemic, or along the way when you were doing Zaman Now, this idea of Pasar Now has been discussed?
We actually saw a trend. So because we work very closely with housewives when we started Zaman Now, we were getting a lot of requests to sell fresh products from a lot of the housewives, because they sell fashion products every day, but fresh products like vegetables, people will buy every day. So we got that, a lot of these requests. So what we did was we started reaching out to third-party suppliers to see if anyone could supply us with fresh vegetables and fruits. But the problem with Zaman Now for fresh products and vegetables is we covered all the way from Aceh to Papua. There's no way you can sell, like send fresh products from Jakarta to Papua or Aceh. So when we started testing it out, we realized we had to make a change if we really wanted to focus on this model.
Okay. Anything you want to add, Cindy?
Ya, jadi ketika awal pandemi juga, kami menyadari bahwa demand untuk lifestyle product tuh menurunnya tuh sangat drastis. Terus habis itu kita coba untuk jual produk dari kategori lainnya. Kita menyediakan kayak perlengkapan kebersihan, kesehatan, kayak mask, hand sanitizer, terus sampai ke fresh product yang tadinya itu emang banyak di request sama apa reseller kita kebanyakan. Dan waktu itu kita masih pakai pihak ketiga. Surprisingly, even after the pandemic happened, fresh product ini akhirnya menjadi best selling itemnya kita. Tapi business model untuk lifestyle product itu nggak bisa atau kurang cocok buat fresh product. Karena benar tadi kata Don, kalau fresh product itu harus dikirim secepatnya. Terus habis itu, customer itu, they have certain quality yang harus kita apa ya, yang harus kita penuhi in terms of fresh product. Karena kalau misalnya fashion tuh ya, kayak misalnya reseller jual fashion item, apa ya, customer tuh ada ekspektasi yang beda-beda antara yang satu dengan yang lain. Kalau untuk fresh product, you know what kind of mango is the right one. Jadi nggak bisa pakai apa business model dengan reseller lagi. Terus habis itu customer service process-nya tuh way more complicated. Kenapa? Karena komplainnya banyak gitu. Terus harus cepat di-handle, terus habis itu pertanyaannya detail, kayak, oh ini jeruknya jeruk apa, dan sebagainya, itu nggak bisa ditangani oleh reseller sendiri, dan harus dari customer service kita sendiri. And yes, all of these problems gave us a new opportunity, di mana akhirnya kita decide untuk ambil kesempatan ini dan apa ya, merubah bisnis model kita dan aplikasi kita supaya bisa memenuhi apa ya, permintaan fresh product ini, dan we can't rely on third party suppliers anymore. So early March itu kita akhirnya coba testing our new hypothesis.
Okay, so early March itu baru kayak benar-benar pivot, full pivot, atau kayak baru adding the fresh product?
We started fresh products. Actually, we started in selling it in JAMA Now, end of 2019, so around December. But around mid-March, we decided to commit to making the changes and figuring out what we needed to do. So before we actually made the change, we had to plan out, okay, if we want to do this, we saw the customer behavior, what are the changes we need to do, and what are the things we need to set up. So some of the things, want to ask a question?
Yeah, so when you launched this new Pasar Now, previously you have the JAMA Now, right? The app.
Yeah.
And then you, in March, you decide you want to launch the Pasar Now as well.
Mm-hmm.
So did you launch a separate app right away, or how? What was your thought process?
Actually, the process was, we had the idea in March that we're going to make this change. And we decided, before we actually commit to making such a big change, because it's a big investment to change completely your business model, we decided we had to test out the hypothesis to make sure that it would really work, it'll catch on to the people. So we decided what were the few things we needed to set up. Number one, we have to have a warehouse. So we invested in a very small warehouse. Number two, to test the idea that we can get Mitras, our agents, to group orders together with their people who live in their neighborhood. We made a very simple website. It took us only a few days to set up the website. And we started running out this minimum viable product, or MVP, for about a month and a half. We launched the MVP actually after the warehouse was set up on the last 2 days of April. And then so we ran the MVP from May to about mid-June before we actually committed and had our own app released. And during that time, we learned a lot. We learned about the customer behavior. So the MVP was actually a great time for us to see how people would react to our app, number one. Number two, what were the things that we needed to set up? So we learned that to be able to sell fresh fruits and vegetables in a timely fashion and get it delivered, we had to manage our own fleet, because if we used a third-party fleet, they would take too long to deliver to the customer. And one thing that people like to do for fresh fruits and vegetables is have COD. So we had to have our own fleet manage the money and how to source the products to get them from the best farmers at the best prices. That was all the things we learned within 1.5 months of having our MVP running.
I see. So what would you say the ups and downs of doing this pivot, especially during COVID time, I guess?
Mm-hmm.
Well, at the beginning, kan, sebenarnya JAMA Now is, we've done pretty good. We have around 24,000 users for JAMA Now. Tapi ketika kita berencana buat pivot, terus menjual fresh products, akhirnya, apa ya, kita harus pikirin impact-nya untuk mereka tuh gimana. Karena sebagian dari usernya JAMA Now ini, reseller kita itu yang mendaftar tuh sudah dari Aceh sampai Papua. Sedangkan untuk Pasar Now itu supaya kita bisa apa ya, supaya kita bisa memberikan pelayanan dengan quality level yang kita harapkan dan lebih maksimal, kita harus mulai itu dari kecil dulu. Kita mulai dari Jakarta dan sekitarnya dulu.
Jadi kayak dari nol lagi.
Terus kemudian gimana cara kita bisa? Tapi nggak juga, karena beberapa reseller kita yang ada di Jakarta dan sekitarnya tuh sekarang udah beralih jadi reseller atau community leadernya Pasar Now. Jadi seperti itu. Terus yang kedua, our team yang kita udah siapkan untuk how to build JAMA Now gitu. Yang sekarang yang tadinya jual baju, jual other lifestyle product, sekarang tiba-tiba jual sayur, buah, sembako, dan lainnya. Jadi downs-nya adalah mereka juga apa ya, harus dengan cepat belajar, terus harus dengan cepat juga bisa adaptasi sama situasi kita yang baru ini.
Tapi kalau dari sisi consumer-nya itu, apakah bisa leverage consumer yang udah pernah join di JAMA Now?
Bisa dan enggak. Pertama tergantung arealnya mereka sekarang ada di mana. Jadi kalau mereka masih di apa namanya, di luar Jakarta dan sekitarnya, tentu aja kita belum bisa. Tapi goalnya nanti kedepannya kita bakal kesana juga. Terus yang kedua, mungkin dari reseller kita yang terbiasa jualan lifestyle product pun, jadi menjual fresh product tuh juga mereka perlu penyesuaian gitu. gimana caranya, terus siapa yang harus ditargetin sama mereka dan sebagainya, itu juga jadi challenge buat mereka.
Ya benar, karena jualan sayur sama jualan baju fashion memang beda banget juga sih. Waktu kita coba acquire semua reseller-reseller kita yang di Jakarta yang jualan fashion, nggak semua bisa jualan sayuran juga karena bahasanya beda, terus target marketnya juga beda. Mungkin kalau fashion lebih gaul, kalau fruits and vegetables lebih ke ibu-ibu. Dan dari MVP kita waktu itu juga kita belajar target mitra-mitra yang bisa jadi good top resellers juga sebetulnya. Yeah. So, helped a lot. Dan mungkin yang tadi pertanyaan ups-nya apa juga, from a tech point of view, I think getting good reviews and customer feedback is very important because it remotivates the team. Especially like Cindy said, we have a team who's selling fashion and all of a sudden we change to selling fresh fruits and vegetables. We have to motivate them. So when they hear the good reviews from our customers getting the products and saying, oh, this is like Ranch Market products with Indomart prices, or they say, oh, the app is very easy to use, it's user-friendly. I think this really helps give us a positive motivation to keep going, and also the team. And seeing the impact this makes on our Mitra is also very important because now we can see the impact that before these people, maybe their daily livelihood is not so much, but now with Pasar Now, they're making an additional 2 to 3 million a month just from sharing a link, receiving orders and doing the last mile delivery. And it's been very positive because month on month, we're growing at least 60%, which is very encouraging for us as founders to keep moving forward with this new business model.
So what's going to happen with Zaman Now?
For now, I think the right thing to do with Zaman Now is to probably put it on hiatus for a while, put it on a break. It is, people are still ordering, we still have resellers, but the number of orders right now, people just don't fancy fashion products. We don't really sell that many fashion products anymore, so it is a bit sad, but it's the responsible thing to do for ourselves as founders, and also our limited resources, we can't spend too much of it focusing on two battles.
I see.
So you will shut it down, like in terms of the app?
We will pause the app, probably turn it off for a while. When the time is right, we might reactivate it, but for now, yeah, we'll probably turn it off.
Okay.